Hey guys, welcome back. And today I am bringing to you my final massive Destash before I go back to Australia. All right, so in my last declutter video, I told you guys that I was gonna be ruthless and I was going to do a massive declutter or destash before I go back to Australia, and that is about 2 weeks from now. So a lot of my things have been are already packed away, including the makeup, so I can't physically show it right now, but I did take pictures of all of them because I sorted out through my makeup collection and I decided which ones I was going to keep and which ones I was going to let go of. Now, if you follow me on social media, especially on Snapchat, you would already know that I sorted my makeup, and I did find a Facebook page of Australian beauty lovers who buy and sell either brand new or underutilized makeup. And so I decided that I was going to sort all of my makeup, especially my palettes, and decide which ones I'm going to let go of. And this is what this video is about. So this is actually going to be two parts. The first part would be showing you what I have decided to declutter, what I've decided to resell, okay? And the second part would be what I have decided to keep, okay? Well, there's still quite a bit of products that I've decided to keep just because I couldn't bear to let go of them. For sentimental reasons and for financial reasons, but mostly it's probably like less than half of what I used to have. And I would also update you on my inventory after I have sorted everything out. So here are the products that I am going to let go of. Because I am no longer into full coverage, high coverage makeup, I'm letting go of my Becca Ultimate Coverage Complexion Cream in Noisette and Bamboo, and finding a new home for it. I'm also going to be letting go of my Olive Radiant Skin foundation from Becca. Letting go of my Stila Trio in Bocce, Rico, and Besso. Going to let go of my ColourPop bronzer in Happy Hour and the eyebrow pencil in Dope Taupe. Letting go of these three lipsticks from CoverGirl, Wet n Wild, and Bourjois. There you go. Those are the names of them. And that's how much product is left. This is a brand new Makeup Forever Aqua Shadow in 20E that I have not opened. We'll be letting that go. As well as this NARS lipstick in Ingrid, which I think I only used twice. So I'm letting that go. Letting go of my Lorac Pro Contour Palette and adding an eyeliner with it. I'm going to let go of my Makeup Revolution Radiance Palette. I have so many highlighters. Going to let go of my W7 in the Nude just because I prefer the Makeup Revolution Iconic for the Naked 3 dupe. Letting go of my Bite Beauty Kit with Coolie, Port Cafe, and Aubergine, as well as Madeira High Pigment Pencil. Gonna let go of my Inglot number 86 eyeliner, which is a dark green. I'm gonna let go of Half Baked and Twice Baked Urban Decay Single Shadow. I don't really use it. I'm gonna let go of my Laura Mercier Golden Mosaic Shimmer Block. This is a mini. Definitely don't use. Letting go of my NARS Dual Intensity Eyeshadow in Phoebe, as well as another one called Himalaya. So I'm going to let those go. I don't really use it. Going to let go of my Kiko Single Shadow in 219, which is a beautiful rose gold. And look at that. Letting go of my full-size Tarte Blush in Fearless, as well as one in Empowered. I just have so many blushes that I don't really reach for this. Letting go of my limited edition MAC Aquatics blush in See Me, Hear Me. This is Extra Dimension. As well as another blush, limited edition from the Wash and Dry collection called Hypnus, which is a beautiful shade, really. This is a highlighter called Freshen Up from the Wash and Dry collection, almost unused. And a Aquatics collection bronzer called Delphic, which is also an Extra Dimension formula. So yeah, letting go of those beautiful, beautiful limited edition products just because I don't reach for them. This is the Revolution Revaholics Lip Kit. I'm going to go let go of that. I have way too much lipstick. Letting go of my Becca Afterglow palette. See that? How pretty it is. Also letting go of my NARS Virtual Domination palette. I just don't use it. I will also be letting go of my Urban Decay with Gwen Stefani collaboration. This is nice, but not nice enough to keep. This is the Urban Decay Vice Pore palette, which I really like, but I just don't really reach for it. So I'm just going to go and let it go. I'm also going to let go of a brand new NARS Pro Prime eyeshadow base and my Soap and Glory sticks. This ones are like highlights, bronzers, and blush. And a NARS Audacious Mascara Mini, a Benefit Their Real Mini Mascara, a Lancome Hypnose Drama Mascara, as well as my collection of Inglot eyeshadows. I just really don't reach for it that much. And finally, my personal Dye Nair Airbrush System. And so there you have it. I took those pictures so that I can post it on the Facebook page and give the people like a good idea of what it actually looks like. So yeah, those are the products that I have been that I have decided to actually let go of. I hope you enjoyed this video and how ruthless I was in choosing what I will let go of, and mostly high-end products because they have better resale values. Okay, especially my limited edition ones. Anyway, so there you go. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and comment down below, when was the last time you destashed and what was the most difficult item that you let go of? Thanks for watching. Bye.